dancers, and that is that when you hoop behind your back so that the hoop stays behind your back the whole time, it allows you to make all these poses. It allows you to travel in interesting ways and wrap the hoop around you in interesting ways. You can do this in both directions. And the basic skills for learning it is basically learning to hold your hoop and do an outside circle so that the hoop is on the fingertips in the sweet spot, that piece of skin between the thumb and the pointer finger. And as long as that stays pointing towards the back, like I'm shaking hands with somebody who's actually behind me, as long as that stays pointing towards the back, I can move the hoop on it wherever I move that. So if I move that high, it looks like this. If I move that low, it looks like this. So that's outside circles. You can also do inside circles. So the hoop is coming in. First, just get used to having it there. Then practice moving it in the low, middle, and high places. And then there's another place that you can hoop behind your back, and that's your thumb. So if you put your thumb in, so now all of your fingers and your thumb are in the hoop at the same time. And then you take your four fingers out, so that now the hoop is just on your thumb. You can hoop on your thumb behind your back, too. I'm in an awkward position right now, but it allows you to do things. This is inside circles. And outside circles, allows you to do things like this toss. Oh, I'm so glad I stuck kind of that. So all of these things that are happening behind the body. You can also do passes where the hoop is spinning behind the body by putting the hands together, back of the hands together, and passing the hoop. Also, just standing, posing, and holding a hoop in a place, you know, and doing something else, focusing on arm work or traveling steps. So, the 80th thing about this is that it looks good in photographs. The hoop is not in front of your face. So if you know you're getting ready to take a picture, anything like this is going to make a nice picture. All right. So, behind the back, that's what I wanted to talk about. Just practice it. You can play anywhere on your fingers from where the thumb connects to the pointer finger and that piece of skin that's your catcher's mitt out to on the first set of knuckles, the second set of knuckles. You're getting kind of risky there because you're getting close to the fingertips. But any of those places, and you have a lot of